Dear student, warm welcome to NPTEL Phase 2 program video course on geosynthetics engineering in theory and practice. My name is Professor J. N. Mandal, Department of Civil Engineering, Indian Institute of Technology, Bombay, Mumbai, India. Now, this lecture number 43, this module 9, lecture 43, geosynthetics for ground improvement. So, for the ground improvement, the outline of this course is introduction, ground improvement technique, consolidation technique, bearing capacity and settlement, principle of prefabricated vertical drain, design chart without and with smear effect, design chart with smear effect and oil resistance, ground instrumentation and monitoring, ground improvement using geocell, and ground improvement using geofoam. So, most of the cases in the soil mechanics, we face the three problems, and that is the strength problem and then the deformation problem and the seepage problem. The strain problem means it is related with the total stress, effective stress, and also that load at any depth where you know that what will be the unit weight of the soil and the depth, then you also can calculate what will be the load due to the unit weight of the soil. And secondly, that deformation problem, and that deformation problem depends upon the what will be the stiffness of the soil, or you can say what will be the either what will be the E value, what will be the G value, that means what is elastic modulus of the soil, what is shear modulus of the soil. And the seepage problem, and it depends upon the what will be the coefficient of permeability of this soil. So, all these three problems can be combined to the consolidation problem, and that combined that what should be the stiffness as well as the seepage. The most important that concept of the soil mechanics is that mechanical behavior that of the soil, that means that is the change in the strain value, and that depend on only the effective stress. So, soil behavior depend on the forces between the particle, and that depend upon effective stress, not the total stress. Because for any ground improvement, effective stress is very important parameter. So, with this background, I will start this introduction. Over the last 40 years, the use of geosynthetics is growing rapidly worldwide. The increasing demand for land reclamation and utilization of soft soil for ground improvement using geosynthetic material. Now, India has a coastal area more than 4,000 kilometers long. The major cities along the coastline congested and development is difficult due to the land and quality of the land. So there is a scarcity of good quality land for future development. Even then, in the city, you can see that there is a problem for the land. Most of the infrastructure have been completed with the good soil, and now you can find there is a soft soil. And in that case, how also you can improve the ground. There are many, many conventional systems are there, and we will study here that how the alternative ground improvement or modification system will be adopted in this course. With the rapid dewinding of the good site for the construction activity of challenging infrastructure project, the need is being increasingly felt for utilizing very low and marginal load bearing site. The need is even greater in high cost metropolitan and the coastal area, where demand for the construction outstrips the land availability. Consequently, many important and major projects such as airways, highways, railways, embankment, large building, container yards and transport terminal have necessarily to be located on area with the soft alluvial and the marine clay deposit of considerable thickness. So due to the very low shearing strength and high compressibility of soil deposit, the shape bearing capacity is very low, and the settlement under nominal structural load tends to be excessive. Hence, it is required to improve the ground by technically feasible and economically viable method for wider application in various projects. It is required to achieve one or more of the following objectives: reduction of post-construction settlement to a tolerable value, then enhancement of shearing strength and hence the bearing capacity of soft soil, and control on rate of loading consistent with the rate of gain in shear strength. So these are the objectives you have to keep in mind, and it should satisfy for the ground modification. Now, geosynthetics are recognized in civil engineering community as cost effective, proven and reliable material to carry out the civil engineering job in better, faster and economical way. The application of geosynthetics are vast because they have versatility in functioning majority as reinforcement, separator, filter, drain and liquid barriers in soil. So these are the main function what we will study, that how we can use the geosynthetic material as a separation, as a reinforcement, as a filtration, as a drainage and even then as a liquid barrier. With the advent of geosynthetics, the revolution of utilizing them in different ground improvement system for weak or soft soil is picking up at an unprecedented pace. With the technical and economic feasibility as the major priority in any upcoming project, so geosynthetics in ground improvement method are the norm of the day. Now, ground improvement technique, what happened if ground improvement is not done. So you see there will be excessive or differential settlement in structure, decrease in structure life, increase in maintenance cost. So we require how to solve this kind of the problem. The ground improvement technique can generally be categorized that you remove and replace, and we use the different consolidation technique, that is we use the sand in stone column, encased sand and stone column, then prefabricated vertical drain with full surcharge and vacuum consolidation with partial surcharge and prefabricated vertical drain, natural prefabricated vertical drain with full surcharge, natural prefabricated vertical drain combined with the stone column or sand column, thermo prefabricated drain, solar power drain, electro osmotic consolidation, vacuum dewatering and dynamic compaction. Geocentric reinforcement technique, that is encased stone column, encased stone column, mechanically stabilized reinforced soil wall, geocell or geowave or geofoam. So you find that different types of the ground improvement technique, and we have to observe that what kind of the system will be more suitable in Indian condition. Some of the system will be very expensive and time consuming in Indian condition. So we have to adopt the proper kind of the ground improvement technique. So we will focus later on detail about that. Apart from this ground improvement, we can go for the densification. Let us say pile, RCC, wooden, steel, composite, dynamic compaction, vibro compaction, compaction grouting. These are all very expensive. Chemical stabilization, you can go lime column, deep soil mixing, jet grouting, injection grouting, then electrokinetic stabilization. So these are the some of the system which we adopt nowadays, but most of the cases what we adopt for the sand in, and now the alternative to the sand in, so you can use the prefabricated vertical band in. So what is prefabricated vertical band in, also we will study, and also we have developed some natural prefabricated vertical drain, and how the natural prefabricated vertical drain also compare with the polyester prefabricated vertical drain, because natural prefabricated drain is available and it is much more cheaper than the polyester prefabricated vertical drain. I will now show you some of the structure where you need the ground improvement. So this is the embankment. What we do that some cases that betterate column is provided. You can see here betterate pile, in order that load can be transferred to this platform, and this is the pile. This is given after Hahn 2003. So nowadays also in some of the project where you are using the pile, and then you can place the layer of the geogrid material here in between the embankment and the top of the cap of the pile, and this geosynthetic reinforcement can prevent the lateral spreading. This also after hand 2003. So, you do not require any better pile, you can simply provide with a layer of geogrid material in between the pile and this embankment, which can prevent the lateral spreading. Now, there are various combination of the use of the stone column or the sand drain, also prefabricated vertical drain and natural prefabricated vertical drain. So, here you can see embankment has been constructed with the stone column. Here this embankment is construction on this sand drain. So, this you have to install the mandrel or casing and push into the soft soil, and then you can fill up with the sand and then pull out the casing. So, you can form the sand drain here. So, alternative to the stone column and the sand drain, so you can adopt the, this is polyester prefabricated vertical drain. And apart from this polyester prefabricated vertical drain, you can alternatively you can do the natural prefabricated vertical drain. So, suppose this is the polyester prefabricated vertical drain. So, this is the core and this is the jacket, and this polyester prefabricated vertical drain, alternative to this, you can use the jute or natural prefabricated vertical drain. So, this is the jute and this is the coir, okay. Coir as a core and jute, it may be the woven or it may be the non-woven. Here it is a non-woven jute material. So, non-woven jute material will act as a jacket and this will act as a core. And also you can construct this woven jute geotextile material as a jacket and also this material or the coir also as a coat. Alternative to this, you can also use the coir as a coat. So, I will show you more about the different type of natural prefabricated vertical drain. And now, you can see here that you can use stone column and prefabricated vertical drain. You can use sand drain with the natural prefabricated vertical drain. Now, you can see sometimes that when you want to use the stone column and also either the natural prefabricated vertical drain or the polyester prefabricated vertical drain. So, this kind of the system, what we call the multiple system, because you are providing the stone column and as well as the natural prefabricated vertical drain. So, natural prefabricated vertical drain will accelerate it, consolidation is very fast. So, there will be a development of excess pore water pressure with the jute or natural prefabricated vertical drain can absorb and can translate on the top of the embankment. That means, the natural prefabricated vertical drain can take care for the settlement, because dissipation excess pore water pressure will reduce in the effective stress, it will increase. But the stone column is very good material to improve the bearing capacity. That means, stone material can take care for the load carrying capacity. So, if you can use combination of the stone column and the natural prefabricated vertical drain. So one will take care for the settlement and other will take care for the bearing capacity. So this kind of the system also in applied in India. Now application of geosynthetics can be perceived in a typical embankment construction. A canal is constructed on the embankment with a layer of geosynthetics clay liner or the geomembrane. Sometimes you can see that if this is the embankment and this is the ground improvement have performed with the prefabricated vertical drain, and this is the foundation compressible soil, and on the top of this embankment you require suppose some canal. So you can place here the geomembrane clay liner or the geomembrane. Even then sometimes you can place the geomembrane and also geocell. So here this geosynthetics material act as a filtration and drainage, and embankment fill can also replace by the lightweight material. You can also replace with the lightweight material like a geofoam. So correct choice of technique for ground improvement. The choice of appropriate technique for ground improvement depend on several factors such as the type of soil and type of improvement required, that is increase in the bearing capacity or decrease in settlement, or both need to be considered. Time and the cost are also very important factor. Consolidation and installation and construction for long time is not suitable for any project, and nobody like that he should continue for a longer time to consolidate the soil. Everybody want to finish the project at the earliest, also because time is money. Application of huge and heavy equipment may increase the cost. The risk of non-performance or cost of time lead to expensive solution. Sometimes the advantage of area of application of the technique can be taken to reduce the cost and time. The embankment can be designed for achieving 80% consolidation, and remaining 20% consolidation can take place during the construction of different pavement layers. The availability of labor and the material also affect the time and cost. Suitability of technology depend on the availability of the resources of the country. Countries such as India, Bangladesh, Pakistan, Myanmar, Thailand, China, etc. have abundant natural material like jute, coir, sisal and bamboo. The geotextile made from such natural material are called as limited life geotextile, or LLGS, reported by Sasby 1997. So here are two issues. Is that when you wanted to construct the embankment on a soft soil and you use any natural prefabricated vertical drain, it takes time to consolidate it, and you have to achieve the 90-95% consolidation. So even then you can go for the 80%, and when the structure is constructing, remaining the 20% or the 15% can be completed. So this will act as a stress loading. And here that most of the cases we use this polyester prefabricated vertical drain. Here as I mentioned that abundant natural material like jute and coir are available in India. So we can manufacture the natural prefabricated vertical drain. I'll also address that some of the natural prefabricated vertical drain also. Now, many of the polymer based geosynthetics can be replaced with degradable and eco-friendly natural geotextile depending on the area of application. Mandel 1987 recommended the use of jute and coir for ground improvement system, and they have the many good technical property. You can see this paper also in International Journal Geotextile and Geomembrane. So they'll give this good property like strength, extensibility, or the stiffness, and flexibility, and durability. So most of the cases you can see when you talk about the natural material and jute and the coir, then everybody asks about what is biodegradable, what is life. So that's why that Dr. Sasvi mentioned it is a limited life, because jute is very good water absorption capacity, 300-400% water absorption. No other material, polymer material, cannot absorb that much percentage of the water. And secondly, for the installation of the prefabricated drain, don't take the major strength, tensile strength of the material, because it is required initially only for the installation. And because jute absorb water and consolidation is very faster, so stabilization will be very faster. Even then, jute deteriorated, that means is water absorption capacity also increased. So consolidation also will be very faster, it accelerated very fast. So that was the main reason that why you can use the jute and the coir as a natural material for the ground improvement. So natural fiber have been used in the construction industry since the 5th or 4th millennia BC. The villagers used mud clay reinforced with straw to build the dwelling units for their shelter. Some vegetable natural fiber have low tensile strength and poor durability. Tarmac's branches was used with the clay and the gravel for the construction of the Great Wall of China in 200 BC. The rope was used for many centuries to lift the heavy load at dockside and mine industries. Currently, renewed natural fiber can be used by automobile industry. The weight reduction of the door panel of car is about 20% using the flax sisal fiber mat embedded in an epoxy resin matrix. So you can see that how the natural material can be used in various applications, even then in the automobile industry. Natural fiber can be utilized in several applications, used for short period of time, unpaved temporary access road, that is separation, the embankment construction on soft clay, that is vessel reinforcement, ground improvement, time dependent due to consolidation and drainage. Currently, jute and coir are the most promising, economically viable, and vegetable fiber fabrics. Those have a high water absorption capacity as well as the lower impact of environment than man-made fiber does. So here you can see that how the natural material is much more suitable for the ground modification, and it is environmental friendly. Also, the natural material can be used for temporary for any purpose. If it is a very soft soil, it is very difficult to cross. So, you can place the natural material and then you can work on the soft soil using the natural material. Where in many army places where they have to cross and they have to build up very temporary some, let us say, mechanically stabilized reinforced soil wall or reinforced soil slope for time being. So, you can construct. You can construct temporary road where soil is very soft. So, you can make use for temporary for any places, even then I am telling that army what we use. So, what we can make use of this natural material. Indigenous natural geotextile have certain major advantage and play significant role in developing countries like India. The raw material are environmental friendly, renewable resources and available abundantly. India is the second largest jute producer in the world, thus making sustainable construction industry. And Bangladesh is the first that jute manufacturing country. Natural biodegradable nourishes soil and return to the ground without pollution. Low unit cost production and conversion cost low, provide competitive cost and economical, create new market to agriculture product, support agro industry and job for the local people. This is very important that how we can make use of the natural material like jute and coir. So, common people can survive, alleviate this poor. This also can be used for the mulching in the agriculture. You can use the jute and coir material for the erosion control and grass can grow. And jute has been used for many, many years for the erosion control, because the grass will grow. And if you pour the water, jute is a very good water absorption capacity and it nutrients. So, grass can survive for a longer time, and also the grass from grow the roots and it stabilized. So, jute has a very important role for the soil erosion. Even then, for the agriculture, you can use jute and coir like a pipe. And then water can pass through the pipe through the jute material, and because the jute also has an opening side and water can be spread through the plant and plant can grow. And it is not necessary that you are to provide the water off and on, because water absorption capacity is more than any other material. So, it has also used in various like this agriculture industry. So, that is why it increases the range of crops. Farmer can cultivate and sell. New market are primarily close to the production point. Money is attached to rural area and region without incurring the major expenditure on transportation, help in bringing down costly import. So, we observe that how we can make use of the natural material jute and coir, and how the common people also will be the benefited. How? The different type of this in infrastructure, we can use the natural material, jute or the coir. Now, we will talk about some consolidation technique and what is happening, what is the mechanics and mechanism of the natural prefabricated vertical drain, how you can improve the ground using this natural prefabricated vertical drain or the polyester prefabricated vertical drain. So, before that we should know what is happening and what we adopt. So, let us study some consolidation technique. Since 1930, sand drain are used in various projects and they are typically 200 millimeter to 600 millimeter diameter vertical drain and spaced at 1.5 to 6 meter interval. The conventional vertical sand drain technique is time consuming and very costly. The availability of good quality sand is becoming scarce in current year. Here you can see that this is the sand drain, this is a very soft clay, you install the sand drain and then you are applying this embankment. And in case of the sand drain, you require what will be the diameter of the sand drain, what will be the spacing of the sand drain, and when you will use the sand drain, it takes to consolidate about 2 years, 3 years, 7 years, even then 22 years. So, one cannot wait for so many years, the when the embankment or the building will come up on that area, because time is money. So, everybody wants to complete the project at the earliest. Even the natural prefabricated vertical drain also have been used in the Singapore, and 5-story construction building also have been completed so many years back. Even after that 5 years, it has been observed it is giving very good drainage. So, you can see that how the natural prefabricated vertical drain have been used, and it is unfortunate in India that nothing natural prefabricated vertical drain have been used, but we have used plenty of the polyester prefabricated vertical drain. And we are the production of the natural jute geotextile material is the second largest in the world in production after the Bangladesh. So, what is happening that if we use this sand drain? So, it takes lot of time, and also as I say that sand also is scarce, not available, because you need that kind of the gradation of the sand to build a sand drain. So, even then that initially NHI project also they do not want to go for the sand drain system, the natural prefabricated vertical drain system or prefabricated vertical drain. So, then I presented in the Delhi for the use of the prefabricated vertical band drain, and then it has been also implemented. It has also been implemented in JNPT in the Bombay and many, many places. I will show you later on some of the case studies where the prefabricated vertical drain also have been used. So, now the recently the prefabricated vertical drain are replacing the sand drain. And compared to the sand drain, the polymer based prefabricated vertical drain is 100 millimeter in width and 3 to 5 millimeter in thickness. It is like this kind of the material. You can see that this is 100 millimeter in width and its thickness may be 3 to 5 millimeter. It may be polyester or it may be the natural material also like this. So, it is with about the 100 millimeter and this thickness may be about 5 millimeter. So, compared to the sand dune, so polyester based prefabricated vertical dune is 100 millimeter in width and 3 to 5 millimeter in thickness. So, here you can, I have shown you the defined types of the prefabricated vertical dune, and this dune has a core wrapped with the geotextile material in case of polyester, and in case of the natural material, this core material is the coir and this wrap with the jute material. Either it is a woven jute geotextile material or the non-woven jute geotextile material. The prefabricated dune have many advantages with respect to the sand dune. The band shape prefabricated vertical dune are easy to install in the soil as well as causes least disturbance to the soil during installation. The discharge capacity of the band dune is more and consolidation rate is higher than that of sand dune. It also decreases the required surcharge for the compression of the soil. So, you can see that because the jute is very good absorption capacity, so discharge capacity is more than the sand dune. So, because discharge capacity is more, acceleration is very fast, so consolidation is very fast, so it takes minimum time to consolidate. So, here on geosynthetics embankment with prefabricated vertical drain. So, this is the PVD are generally placed to 1 meter to 5 meter in spacing, and you can see you can provide with the proper kind of the drainage in order that the water, there will be radial drainage and also vertical drainage, then water can pass through this drainage. So, some outline that we have developed some prefabricated natural drain. So, we should know what will be the properties of the marine clay and natural prefabricated vertical drain, what you can use the natural prefabricated vertical drain in a marine clay. And one of the most also important factor also filtration characteristics of the jute and the polymer geotextile filter. So, this is the application area of prefabricated vertical drain. You can see this is soft soil where this is prefabricated vertical drain, and you can place a geotextile material here. Because you provide with the 3 to 400 or 500 millimeter thickness of the sand as a drainage material, you sometimes may not be required, you can provide with the geotextile or the geocomposite material, then water can be drained it out. And it can be, it in be used for the storage tank. This also type of the storage tank has been used in India, and this is the polyester based prefabricated vertical drain. I mentioned this is the filter and this inside is the core. Now, common application area of prefabricated vertical drain, PVDs, it can be used for the highway, that is roadway, structure application field, etcetera, airfield, that is runway, taxiway, cargo, apron and the building, earth dam, that is foundation, embankment and levees, storage tank, excavation, that is steep and allowable slope, waste pond and mine tailing pond, building, that is industrial plant, warehouses, wastewater treatment plant, an apartment and shopping center. So, these are the places where you can use this kind of the natural prefabricated drain. And one of the most important in case of the natural prefabricated vertical drain, this is made from natural material like jute and coir, and it is eco-friendly. it is hygroscopic and it is indigenous and economically and when it is available abundantly. So, it is not so much costly and also it is environmental friendly and also it is abundantly available. Now, some studies have been performed in IIT Bombay by Dr. Asha. This is the sum that aim and objective of this present study, that to study some of the major properties such as the tensile strength and the discharge capacity of the natural prefabricated vertical drain and soil retention ability and clogging potential of natural geotextile filter material, which are essential to ascertain their efficiency and utility. So, here is the properties of the remolded marine clay. You can see this property, what are the test method as per IS, and these are the value. So, here the specific gravity 2.60, liquid limit 82%, plastic limit 40%, sinkage limit 10%, plasticity index 42, seal content 33.7%, clay content 51.0%, then compression index C0 0.75, soiling index CS 0.11. So, this classifies as a clay of high plasticity, that is CH, as per Indian standard classification system IS 498. So, this is the natural prefabricated vertical drain, can also be developed using the natural geotextile such as jute and coir, especially in country like India, where they are available in abundance. You can see this is the polyester prefabricated vertical drain, and these are the different type of the natural prefabricated vertical drain have been developed. So, this is the natural prefabricated vertical drain 1, where it is a jacket is the open geotextile material and then coil is act as a core material. And this is natural prefabricated vertical drain 2, where the jacket is made of non-oven jute geotextile material and the coil as a core material. Here again, the natural prefabricated vertical drain 3, here you can see that jacket is made of the oven geotextile material and this the coir is like a mat, coir mat has been used. So, this is natural prefabricated vertical drain 3, and then also this natural prefabricated vertical drain 4 with the different pattern of the mat. It also depend on that what will be the pattern of the core material, then how can water can flow through this core material, how the discharge can take place through this core material, or in case of here also there will be, it will act like a filament and it is act like a composite material. So, this is the newly developed natural prefabricated vertical drain made of jute and the coir geotextile, Asha and Mandal 2012. So, we have performed some test on this natural prefabricated vertical drain and we have determined that what will be their physical properties for both the natural prefabricated vertical drain and also polyester prefabricated vertical drain, and then you can compare and can observe whether it is suitable, that whether we can use the natural prefabricated vertical drain or not, whether it satisfies all the requirement or all the properties and criteria. So, here is the physical description of the prefabricated. This is natural prefabricated vertical drain type 1. This is single layer open geotextile material and core 5 number of 5 millimeter diameter of coir standard and width is from 85 to 90 millimeter, and thickness of the PVD is 9 millimeter. In case of NPVD2, this is a filter is single layer non-woven jute geotextile material, 5 number of 5 millimeter diameter quiet stand, and width is 85 to 90 millimeter, and thickness is about 11 millimeter. NPTD3, that is single layer woven jute geotextile material, and coir is 10 millimeter thick flat coir mat, and width is 85 to 90 millimeter, and thickness is 12 to 12.5 millimeter. Now NPVD4, that is filter is single layer woven jute geotextile material, and core is 13 millimeter thick corrugated coir mat, and the width is 85 to 90 and thickness about 16 to 16.5 millimeter. Whereas polyester prefabricated vertical drain, this is a single layer non-woven polypropylene, and core material is 4.5 millimeter thick corrugated and studded polypropylene sheet, and the width is 100 millimeter and thickness is 5 millimeter. Also it vary from 95 to 100, and thickness also vary from 3 millimeter to 5 millimeter. So you can see that what is the variation of the width and the thickness. So width and thickness also very important, because we have to check up that equivalent diameter of the sanding, and then if we can calculate, you can find that equivalent diameter is the same, almost the same with respect to the sanding. And when we design, I will explain more about this. Now properties of the filter and core. So you ought to also have to determine what will be the property. You can see this is the structure, the filter type, and this is the test method, woven jute. This is the non-woven jute textile material, and this is the non-woven polypropylene material. And this all the test has been performed as per ASTM and also IS. So here mass per unit area, in case of woven 700 gram per meter square, and non-woven is 680 gram per meter square, while non-woven polypropylene is 100 gram per meter square. Thickness in case of woven jute, this is 1.8 millimeter, and non-woven it is 6 millimeter, and this in case of polypropylene, this is 0.5 millimeter. Now tensile strength is 29 kilonewton per meter. For non-woven jute is 5 kilonewton per meter, and non-woven polypropylene is 50 kilonewton per meter. Now elongation for woven is 8.4%, for non-woven jute is 25, and this non-woven polypropylene is 25%. Then puncture strength in kilonewton, it is woven jute is 0.62 kilonewton, non-woven jute is 0.46 kilonewton, and this is non-woven polypropylene is 1 kilonewton. Trapezoidal tearing strength, this is woven jute is 0.53 kilonewton, and non-woven 0.12, and non-woven polypropylene 0.8. Similarly, coir type, that is diameter for coir stand is 5 millimeter, thickness for flat coir is 10 millimeter, and corrugated coir mat is 13 millimeter. And tensile strength is for the non-woven geotextile material is 44.8 kilonewton per meter, and this is 12 kilonewton per meter. Elongation at break is for non-woven jute material is 40%, woven jute material is 23%, and non-woven polypropylene geotextile material is 19%. So these are the properties of the material, that what is the core material, and also what is the jacket material. Now some also that physical properties of the NPBD and PBD. This is the type, that sheet type. You can see that for the natural material 1, 2, 3, 4, what we have used, you know, this is the quiet type, we know what we have used, and what is the thickness at 2 kilopascal. For the woven jute 9 millimeter, non-woven jute 11 millimeter, woven jute 12 to 12.5 millimeter, and this is woven jute 16 to 16.5 millimeter, and in case of the PPBD this is 5 millimeter. Weight per meter, this for NPPD 184 to 185, NPTD 2 160 to 165 gram, and NPTD 3 270 to 280, and woven jute is 310 to 326, and for PPBD is 85. Tensile strength kilonewton per 85 millimeter wide again. So this is for NPTD 1 is 6.2, NPTD 2 is 2.25, NPTD 3 is 5.76, and NPTD 4 is 5.76, and PPTD is 8. And elongation at break for NPTD 1 10%, NPTD 2 25%, NPTD 3 10%, NPTD 4 10%, and PPBD is 35%. Another important parameter, that is discharge capacity, that is meter cube per second at the hydraulic gradient I is equal to 0.5 under 250 kilopascal stress. So here for NPTD 1 is 2.8 to 10 to the power minus 6, that is meter cube per second, and NPTD 2 is 0.9 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter cube per second, and NPTD 3 2.5 into 10 to the power minus 6 meter cube per second, and NPTD 4 is 4.25 into 10 to the power minus 6, and for PPBD is 13.5 into 10 to the power minus 6. So you see that what is the properties of this natural material. Now this you can say that some test properties for weight per meter, it vary 180 to 185 for NPTD 1, NPTD 2 160 to 165, NPTT 3 270 to 280, and NPTT 4 310 to 325, and PPTD 85. Tensile strength, which also lies between 6.2 for NPTD 1, 2.25, NPTD 2, 5.90 for NPTT 3, and 5.60 for NPTT 4, and PPBD is 23. Elongation also for NPTT 1, 10, NPTT 2, 25, NPTT 3, 10, NPTT 4, 10, and PPTD 22. Tensile strength at 10%. This is also important because we require that what will be the tensile strength at 10% strength. For NPTT 1, the strength is 6.2 kilonewton, for NPTT 2, 1.25 kilonewton, and for NPTT 3, 5.90, for NPTT 4 is 5.60, and PPBD is 15 kilonewton. Generally, widely recommended criteria tensile strength of the whole prefabricated den should be greater than 1 kilonewton at 10% strain. So, as for Cohenal 1994 and Royce 1997 and Bo ETL 2003. So, we observe that if the PBD value is greater than 1, then it satisfies the criteria. So, here we observe that tensile strength of the natural material is satisfying the criteria. So, we can make use of this natural material as a prefabricated vertical den for the ground improvement. Standard deviation and coefficient of variation of tensile strength. These are the material woven jute jerry textile filter, the standard deviation 2.69 and coefficient of variation 0.09. Non-woven jute jerry textile filter, standard deviation 2.24 and coefficient of variation 0.44. Quiet stand as a core material, standard deviation 0.05 and coefficient of variation 0.24. Flat quiet mat as a core material, standard deviation 9.13 and coefficient of variation 0.186. Corrugated quiet mat core, standard deviation 2.08 and coefficient of variation is 0.17. NPVD 1, the standard deviation 0.46 and coefficient variation 0.07. NPVD 2, the standard deviation 0.34 and this is factor 0.14. NPTT 3, standard deviation 0.87 and this correlation factor is 0.14. NPTT 4, that standard deviation 0.30 and correlation factor is 0.05. So, what we can do summary and the conclusion from this study, that all the natural prefabricated particle dam have the adequate tensile strength to resist the tensile force of 1 kilonewton at a tensile strain of 10%. That what we require. The highest average maximum tensile strength is obtained in natural prefabricated particle dam 1, while the lowest in natural prefabricated particle dam 2. With this, I ended up the lecture today. Please let us hear from you any question. Thanks for listening.